Welcome students, welcome to engineering chemistry class unit 3 lesson 3. So in this lesson we are going to learn the Nernst equation, the derivation. We are going to learn the types of batteries, and in primary cells lithium battery we are going to see, and in secondary battery lithium ion cells we are going to see. So what is Nernst equation? Already you have studied in inter. This Nernst equation is used to calculate the electrode potential, that is cell potential of electrochemical cell at any given temperature, pressure and the concentration of the electrolyte. So this equation was introduced by a German scientist or German chemist called Walther Hermann Nernst. So the Nernst equation for single electrode potential is given by the equation E cell is equal to E naught minus RT by NF ln Q, where E cell is the cell potential of a cell, E naught is the cell potential under standard conditions, that is the room temperature, 1 atmospheric pressure and the 1m concentration. Where R is the universal gas constant, that is 8.314, T is the temperature, N is the number of electrons involved in the redox reaction, F is Faraday's constant and Q is reaction quotient, that is the product, that is the concentration of product by reactant. So the calculation of single electrode potential from the standard single electrode potential for an atom or ion is given by the Nernst equation. For reduction reaction, Nernst equation is given as Mn plus plus Mn n times of electron gives Nm. Okay, the reduction potential is given by the equation E naught of Mn plus by M is equal M minus 2.303 into RT by NF log of 1 by concentration of metal ions. Where R is the gas constant, we know that, and the N is the number of electrons, T is absolute temperature, F is Faraday or Coulomb, that is 96500, and Mn is active mass of the ions. For simplicity, it may be taken as equal to the molar concentration of the salt, and the Nernst equation at 25 degrees Celsius is E naught minus 0.0591 divided by N into log of reaction quotient, that is Q. Therefore, as per Nernst equation, the overall potential of an electrochemical cell is depend on the reaction quotient. And the derivation, consider any metal in contact with the solution of its own salt, and the reactions of metal losing an electron is to become an ion, and the ion gaining electron to return to the atomic state or equally feasible and or in equilibrium state. So the reaction is Mn plus plus n electron gives n times the metal. If the reduction reaction n moles of an electron is taken up by the ion against reduction potential of the E. So the work done in the moment of electron is given by W is equal to NFE, where F is the Faraday, that is the electrical charge carried by one mole of electrons. So first consider the work done in the moment of electron, that is the electron is passing through the circuit. So it is expressed by W equal to NFE. So there is a change in the Gibbs free energy, which is an indication of a spontaneous reaction, and it is also equal to the maximum useful work done in the electrochemical process. So combining the work done and the Gibbs free energy change, W, that is work done, is equal to NFE, that is equal to minus G. So if minus G means the work is spontaneous, that is the reaction is spontaneous. So delta G is equal to minus NFE. NFE is the final formula. So change in free energy at standard conditions of room temperature and one molar concentration and one atmospheric pressure is delta G naught. Delta G naught is standard conditions. where delta G is working condition. So from the above relation, it can we can written as delta G naught is equal to minus NF E. So where E naught is the reduction potential measured at standard conditions. So during the reaction, concentration keeps on changing and the potential will also decrease with the rate of the reaction. So to get the maximum work or maximum free energy change, the concentration have to be maintained at the same. So this is possible only by carrying out the reaction under a reversible equilibrium condition. So for reversible equilibrium reaction, Van't Hoff isotherm says delta G is equal to delta G naught plus RT ln K, where K is the equilibrium constant, K is the concentration of product by reactant, and R is the universal gas constant, T is the temperature in Kelvin scale. So substituting for free energy change in Van't Hoff equation, and on deriving, we will get the final equation E naught of mn plus by m minus 0.0591 by n into log of 1 by mn plus concentration of mn plus. So pause this video and go through the derivation. It is very simple as you have already studied in the inter. And what are the applications of Nernst equation? It can be used to calculate the single electrode potential at any conditions. And it is used to calculate the standard electrode potential and comparing the relative ability as a reductive, reductive or oxidative agent is possible. And for finding the feasibility of the combination of such single electrodes to produce electric potential, it is used to find out the EMF of an electrochemical cell and unknown ionic concentrations. And the pH of solutions and the solubility of sparingly soluble salts can be measured with the help of Nernst equation. Yes, coming to the batteries, battery can be defined as a device which contains two or more electrochemical cells connected in series and that can be used as a source of direct electric current at constant voltage. They are of two types, one is primary battery and another one is secondary battery. What is a primary battery? The cells in which the cell reaction is not reversible. Once the cell reaction is completed, all the reactants are exhausted, then no more electricity is produced and the battery becomes dead. It cannot be recharged again. That is called primary batteries. And what are secondary batteries? They can be reversed by passing direct electric current in opposite direction. Thus, a secondary battery may be used through a large number of cycles of discharging and charging. Okay, and for example of primary batteries, we can use the primary batteries in watches, calculators, torch light, etc. Okay, Leclanché cell, dry cell, alkaline battery are the examples of primary batteries, whereas secondary batteries are lithium ion cells, which are used in the electric vehicle and laptop, computer, mobile phones, etc. They can be recharged. Lead acid battery also come under secondary batteries. Okay, so the primary batteries are non-rechargeable and are less expensive and often used in the ordinary gadgets like torchlight, watches and toys. And coming to the lithium cells, so first we'll see about the primary battery lithium cell. Okay, in primary batteries we'll see the examples like lithium cells. A lithium battery comprised of lithium as an anode. Lithium is gaining a lot of popularity nowadays because it was the lightest of all metals and highest standard oxidation potential, that is 0.305 volt. So it has highest energy density and they are of three types: solid cathode lithium cells, liquid cathode lithium cells and solid electrolyte lithium cells. First we'll see the liquid cathode lithium cells. They are used in military and space applications and medical devices such as neurostimulators, in drug delivery systems and in some electronic circuit boards for supplying fixed voltage for memory protection. In liquid cathode lithium cells, the anode is lithium and the cathode is thionyl chloride, that is SOCl2, and the electrolyte is LiAlCl2. Okay, so the anodic reaction, lithium undergoes oxidation, and the cathodic reaction, the cathode SOCl2 will accept the electrons and it will give a lithium chloride and will also liberate sulfur dioxide and sulfur. So the net reaction is this one, lithium chloride is the final product. And coming to the solid cathode lithium cells, the anode is lithium. In all the lithium cells, anode will be the lithium and the cathode will be changing. So thionyl in liquid cathode lithium cell, thionyl chloride SOCl2 is a liquid. In solid cathode lithium cells, MnO2 is a solid. So this is this example comes under solid cathode lithium cells. Manganese dioxide is a cathode. So electrolyte is lithium salts mixed in organic solvents. Any lithium salts like lithium chloride, lithium fluoride, etc. is mixed in the organic solvents such as 1,2-dimethoxyethane, propylene carbonate, carbon tetrachloride, etc. Okay, so the anodic reaction will be the lithium undergoes oxidation to liberate electrons, and cathodic reaction the oxidation state of manganese dioxide oxidation state of manganese in manganese dioxide is 4, which undergoes reduction to get Mn3. Then the net reaction will be like lithium manganese dioxide LiMnO2. So this type of solid cathode lithium cells are used in watches, calculators, memory applications. And coming to the secondary battery, lithium ion battery, it is a rechargeable portable battery in which lithium ions move from negative electrode to positive electrode. These batteries use an intercalated lithium compound as one of the electrode material, and these batteries possess high energy density, tiny memory effect and low self discharge. And the components present in lithium ion battery are anode, that is carbon. Carbon is taken in the form of graphite. In the graphite layer, it is intercalated with the lithium. Intercalated means insertion. Okay, in the graphite layer, in between two layers, lithium metal is in form of any salt, it is intercalated. Okay, so the cathode is made up of any metal oxides like lithium cobalt oxide or lithium manganese magnesium oxide, lithium titanium oxide. Also we can use lithium tin, any metallic oxides in the combination of lithium, we can use it as a cathode. Electrolyte is, it is made up from a non-aqueous lithium hexafluorophosphate of lithium perchlorate. Cathode is made up of iron, the efficiency will be more for lithium ion batteries. And the discharging reaction and the charging reactions are shown here. See, I told you the anode consists of graphite, which is intercalated. Intercalated lithium acts as a anode. I told the sheets are graphite sheets, and in between graphite sheets, lithium ions are intercalated, and the anode and cathode are separated using a thin membrane, and the electrolyte is lithium hexafluorophosphate or lithium perchlorate can be used as an electrolyte. So this is the charging and discharging mechanism, and reactions are shown in this slide. So the advantage of lithium ion batteries are they are rechargeable and portable, and no thermal runaway due to overheating or over recharge with these batteries. They are less toxic and they can be recycled also. The applications are lithium batteries are used in Boeing 787 Dreamliner. They make use of these batteries, and they most commonly used for home electronics. I hope you understand. Thank you for watching.